Hey guys, I hope you all are doing well. Today I'm back with another recipe. This is another student special and we're going to be doing it in our little taste and tradition style. It's known as the Thai chili chicken recipe.
To begin the recipe, we wash our chicken breast, then we cut it into thin slices, after which we've cut it into cubes. After this, I'm going to be chopping some fine garlic. We are now looking at the ingredients that we need, which is obviously your chicken breast, which we've already mentioned. Salt, as per your taste. There is chopped garlic. There is soy sauce, which is 2 tablespoons. There is chili powder, you can take 2 tablespoons. There's grounded black pepper, which is 1 tablespoon. There's Thai chili sauce from the market. There are peanuts. There's dry whole red chili. There's sesame oil, that is my preference, but you can also get any kind of vegetable oil, which is cooking oil in this case. Add soy sauce to the chicken breast cubes, followed by the black pepper. Salt as per your liking and taste. Now we add the garlic, after which we add the chili powder, again as per your taste and liking. Give it a good mix. We are going to be adding some sesame oil to the pan on low-medium heat. After which, you add the garlic. On top of which, you add the red chilies. After that, you put in the peanuts. Now, your chicken can be added to the mixture. You can give it a good stir over here. You let it cook for about 10 to 15 minutes, 15 being the maximum. You should keep an eye on the pan and give it an occasional mix because the chicken breast is tender and should be uniformly cooked. After this, we're going to be adding the most important ingredient, which is the Thai chili sauce. Why we add this is because it enhances flavors, gives a bright red color, thickens and forms a juicy gravy. Keep stirring the cubes so that they are evenly cooked. Since chicken breast is tender, it should not take more than 15 minutes and is ready to go. You can enjoy this dish with rice, noodles, or even on its own. Now our dish is ready to be served.
So guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed cooking. Please be sure to like, share and subscribe to Taste and Traditions, and please drop down your comments in the comment section below, and we'll be really looking forward to reading them. Thank you.